Pateicīgi. Un tas stūvis, tāpēc, ko un te bija tāda viris, un atantīgi, ka jā, the chance to meet you yet. My name is Matriona, and I'm what you would call Matryoshka. Or you might know me by name Russian doll. I'm one of those dolls that nest a few more dolls inside. So, and today I know that you came here to try and be one, and I would love to take care of your image here and try and make you into a beautiful Matryoshka, just like me, just like this wonderful one too. You can see that there are certain features that are very popular and sort of a standard. And that's most of the time blushy cheeks, pinkish lips, bluish eyes, but not necessarily any complexion would look just perfect. And then, of course, lashes that just go forever. And, of course, cute little eyebrows. And then we're going to choose one of the shawls for you, just like these. I'll put this one down. We'll just pick one of these, and you can wear your shawl just like I do and become a real Matryoshka. So I'm going to do your makeup, and at first let me just take a look at you, see what I can highlight and bring up, and maybe just play up a little bit more. And I have to say, you're extremely attractive. I hope you don't mind the compliment. I love your cheekbones. I really like your face features. I like your head. I can tell it's very soft. I can tell you take care of yourself. Well, and while we are talking, I'll tell you a little bit about the history of Matryoshka. And that's actually something that came to life before revolution in Russia. And I like to do it like that. Like a real artist, you know. Okay. So originally Matryoshka stands for the word mother. Or might, or in Latin it's mater, I believe, and it just means a mother. So Matryoshka, or me, is a symbol of caring, protecting, and feminine women. So today, I would love you to be a part of it. Of course, it doesn't have to be just women. It can be men, it can be animals, anything that carry a symbol of protection and care and love and softness in a way. So I hope you enjoy this trip with me. And I like to start by just using my big brush just to cleanse your face a little bit. Understanding, and then just this cheek right start, I like to use this Urban Decay eyeshadow potion, primer potion for your eyes, and I like to use it as well as on the top lid and on the bottom one as well. Okay, just to open it, dab a little bit of it on my finger. Some concealer, and I usually use two types of concealer. The first one is just cover stick, and it's just a white concealer stick, and I usually just dab it with my finger and place it inside and underneath my eyes in the corners. And also, I just dab it on any red spots that I'm trying to cover as well. So just scarring or just blemishes, you know. So let me just put it a little bit under your eye, right here, just dabbing it. Okay. And the same thing on the other side. Beautiful. And then on top of the white concealer, I usually place regular concealer. This one is light vanilla by NARS. I have to say, I've used different ones and I've purchased expensive one for the first time, and I don't. So, while I like the coverage of this one without this Maybelline white stick, it wouldn't truly work as well. So I suggest you get just a regular concealer and the white stick with it. Okay, and I just open it up. Pretty eyes, красивые глазки. Okay. So the next step is to do your eyebrows, and I have a very old pencil. It is my grandmother's pencil, and I've been using it ever since I started doing my makeup, since I was about 13. Small it is, but not so good in using liquid eyeliners, so I prefer pencils. And I have this one by CoverGirl, and it's called Basic Black. There's a smudger on the end and a pencil on the other end. So I'll just use a pencil to create a beautiful winged look. For that, I'll need to close one eye at a time. Let's do this eye first. Okay, ready? I'll just hold your head still with you. Okay, and I'm going to start drawing a line from the inside of your eye, of your eyelid. Good. You're really getting up. Okay, so now we're going to do eyeshadow. And as I said before, I don't always use expensive cosmetics. I prefer to use things that I have tried and seem to work for me. So I usually use for this look Maybelline New York. Let's see what shade is it. I think it's called Designer Chocolates Eyeshadow. Yes. I'll make sure to put all the tips of the description for you, so you know. And I use brush set. By Sonia Kashuk, but of course I'm not sponsored by anyone. These are just my things that I use. So the set looks like this. This is a brush set. We have small. Your eyes, it will help you create a feeling of your eyes being set and positioned correctly. And you can really play off the shape of your eye with these techniques, with the creasing. Because if your eyes are set too close or too far, just a little adjustment on inside of the eye, on outside of the eye, could actually create a difference in the way your eyes are set. And then we have just the eyelash eyeshadow brush, just a little fella. Okay. And I'm going to be using them. First, I'll take the crease brush and I'll use this brown color. I'm sorry, it's all very dusty and it's just because I use it often. So I'll take this brown one. So if you close your eye, I will just create a crease for you. Okay. Okay. Shimmery mauve color, I guess it's called mauve, right? I'm not sure. But this mauve color, and I put it right on top of the brown color. Okay, so we're going to do that. Close your eye. And by that, I think it creates a more natural look. A more neutral. Now for the base. For the base is everything from the eyeliner up until your eyebrow. I'm going to fill in with this more neutral nude color. skin down on the bottom eyelid, I put a little bit of this blue color. I put it very often, and sometimes you don't even know that it's there, but it gives my eyes more blue color. And you know, if you don't have lashes. I don't think we need it. So now we just need to dry it up a bit. Do you mind if I blow? Yeah. very nice. Next step is foundation, and now I've been using this natural finish oil free foundation by Cover FX. It's not bad, but I don't think this is my last foundation, so to say, that I will try. I might try other ones. It is oil free, but it's not matte. Listener, we're going to do some of your countering. And I tried this Mark Jacob sculpting kit. It's called Dream Filter. I can't say that this is my favorite again, unfortunately. Use a little blush, just like mine here, pink. And I have a very old set, it's Pink Rose by Revlon. And I like this shade of pink, so I use it often. So, you look like a real doll. So now for the last thing is we're going to apply powder all over your face. It's a setting in place. There it is, created. Yes. Mm-hmm. Good. And the last step is to put this makeup setting spray. And I'll just spray it on your face. Okay. So close your eyes. And for this look, I use two lipsticks and a pencil. The pencil is Anti-Visiting Lip Liner in Color Rose by L'Oreal. Color Each. I hope you can see something. So let's outline your lips to give them more definition. Okay. Very gently. Warm up, which is more nude color. And then I go inside the lips with this pink and proper.
Mm-hmm.